We want to determine each function value from the graph provided. So when something is given in function notation, as we see here, f of negative 4, we need to remember that this negative 4 is the x value, or the input, and then the output of the function value will be the y value. So for f of negative 4, we'll find negative 4 on the x-axis, which is here, and then we'll move up to the function. This is where x is equal to negative 4, then the function value is equal to the y value, which we can see here, is equal to positive 3. So f of negative 4 is equal to 3. I think it's important to recognize that what this means is the function is going to contain the point with an x-coordinate of negative 4 and a y-coordinate of 3. Next, we want to determine the value of f of 1. So they're telling us that the x value is equal to 1. We want to determine y when x is equal to 1. So we'll find 1 on the x-axis, which is right here, go up to the function, which is right here, and determine the y value of this point, which would be our function value, which looks like it will be 1/2. So f of 1 is equal to 1/2. So again, knowing this, this means that the point with an x-coordinate of 1 and the y-coordinate of 1/2 would be a point on the function. The last example, we have f of 6, so now we know x is equal to 6. We want to determine the corresponding y value when x is 6. So we'll find 6 on the x-axis, which is here. Go down to the function, which should be here. And then the y value or function value we can see would be equal to negative 2. So f of 6 equals negative 2, which means the function contains the point with an x-coordinate of 6 and a y-coordinate of negative 2.